A few weeks ago, I switched from my old editing program to DaVinci Resolve. It's free, it's great, but there was one big problem with my current workflow and Resolve. When I render my video, I choose a lossless video codec for the rendering, and then I compress that video with Handbrake, because with Handbrake, MP4 videos look way better than almost any editing software can do, and also the files are oftentimes smaller as well, and I just got way more control about what the end product is going to look like. So I used my favorite intermediate video codec, it's called UT Video, and the problem is now that Resolve doesn't support custom codecs. But Resolve does have some lossless codecs, so what I was trying to do is compare every lossless codec and see which one I am going to use from now on. And because I haven't found any video on this, I thought I could make a video myself. I compared Cineform, DNxHRHQ, at first with the constant checkbox ticked and also without the constant bitrate checkbox ticked. I also tested uncompressed, and I also tested just creating a H.264 file but with 100 mbits. I recorded with 100 mbits, so in my mind exporting with 100 mbits should be almost no quality loss. At one point I noticed that some container formats were slower than others. MOV was usually the fastest, and for example AVI was way slower than MOV. So what I did was I also compared for every codec which container would be faster. The measurements that I took was render time, file size of the initial render, the bitrate of the initial render, in which video player you could play the initial render, then the Handbrake render time, the Handbrake compressed video size and compressed bitrate, and the quality of the resulting video, how it looked. So at first I just used Cineform. I used Cineform, created an AVI file, and the problem with that, why I even thought about comparing codecs and using a different codec, is that a 20-minute Cineform AVI file was like almost 200 gigabytes. I mean, I have enough hard drive space for this. That isn't the problem, I have 4 terabytes of space, but this file is so big that Handbrake crashed a few times when trying to compress it, and deleting the file after I was finished was almost impossible. Windows wouldn't let me delete the file. The Windows Explorer always crashed when I left click on the file, so I needed to try and delete it without doing that, and every other way that I tried to do it, like with the command line, it just crashed. The file is so large that Windows couldn't handle me deleting it. And the resulting video didn't look amazing, so that's why I wanted to compare video codecs. For testing, I rendered a 1-minute clip. I played Deep Rock Galactic, that's how the game is called. I put in some dark scenes, some bright scenes, and some scenes with a lot of movement. It was in 1440p, 60fps. To conclude early, uncompressed is terrible for this use case. First of all, the render time is ridiculous. Look at this. Uncompressed in AVI took 8 minutes. Look at this graph. The size of the file was also ridiculous. 26.5 gigabytes for 1 minute. It's so overkill. It also wasn't playable in Windows Film and TV. It could open in MPC HC and in VLC. You could open the files, you just couldn't watch it. It was at 2 frames per second, and it also stopped and loaded a few times. It's you can't really watch it. The Handbrake time was also by far the longest. It's just way too overkill. If you render your intermediate file to a very fast SSD, like to a PCIe 4 M.2 SSD, this could theoretically not be a problem. Like, you could have less problems than I did. I have this on a spinning hard drive, on a slow hard drive. If you have a really fast SSD, this could not be a problem, but it's still way too big, so Windows would crash and Handbrake takes too long and the render takes too long. I will exclude uncompressed from the graphs from now on, just don't use it. Yeah, as I said, MOV was almost always faster than every other container. It still looks the same, it's the same file size, it just renders faster. So just use MOV. Nothing, except for H.264, did play in the Windows Film and TV app. Please download a different program if you want to view these videos. Everything except for Cineform did open in MPC HC. And for Cineform, the problem is that Resolve uses a 32-bit version of the Cineform codec, and MPC HC only supports a 64-bit version. I haven't managed to fix it, but theoretically, you could fix it, I think. I just haven't managed to do it myself. Everything else played, and in the VLC media player everything played. Now we go through the graphs. Render times were quite comparable if you only look at the MOV files. DNxHR did render a bit faster, especially variable was almost half the render time of Cineform. The DNxHR variable is the smallest file size, except for H.264, which is obviously the even smaller file, just had 100 Mbits. The bitrate, it's 87 Mbits, not 100. So yeah, I don't know why it saved so much bitrate, because it looked terrible. I can spoil that much, it looked very compressed. The bitrate for the other files was interesting, to say the least. Windows didn't know what to do. The Cineform files were fine, Windows just said 900 Mbits, that's probably correct. For the DNxHR MOV files, it showed the bitrate, and it was 200 Mbits for constant and 500 for variable, even though I think in the settings I put it on 500 in constant mode, so I don't know why it's that low. And for variable, this is probably not the average, but the peak, or maybe it's the average, I don't know, but you can see the file size is way smaller. If the bitrate is higher, but the file size is smaller, it sounds really good. That's usually a good thing. The handbrake render times were also quite comparable. 20 seconds saved for DNxHR, and then another 10 seconds saved for H.264. So yeah, very comparable. For a 10 to 20 minute video, if you choose one codec over the other, you will like only render 1 minute or 2 minutes longer in handbrake. The resulting size and bitrate were also extremely comparable. For some weird reason, Cineform had the least bitrate in the smallest file size, and I think that showed, because in my perceived quality test, where I just clicked on every video and tried to see with my eyes which looked better, in that test, Cineform looked the worst. Except for H.264, obviously. Cineform looked way worse than the others, and that's probably the reason. Handbrake, for some reason, gave it less bitrate, and that made it probably look worse. Because afterwards, I compared the source files, I will show that shortly as well, but Cineform looked way better than DNxHR, way, way better. So I don't know what the weird issue is with Handbrake, or why Handbrake decided to give the Cineform video less bitrate, but that's probably why my perceived quality is so much worse compared to the others, even though the source file is way better. Now let's look at the source file comparisons. I just zoomed at a significant portion, for example, a bit of grass, or where the background was separating, or where there was text. I zoomed really far into it, and then I switched between the screenshots from Cineform, DNxHR, uncompressed, and I just compared these files. DNxHR has one big issue. Up to this point, DNxHR was my favorite, but this comparison test made one really big issue obvious. Do you see these lines in the background? I don't know if this will be in every game. I might need to test this in more games. This was in all four DNxHR files, and this was in no other codec, and it's extremely weird. It looks terrible. I have to say that it just doesn't look good. To be fair, after the handbrake compression, these lines go away because they get compressed. But for an intermediate file, before it gets compressed, you want to have a video that's as clean as possible. So handbrake can work with the best of the best. You hear often the saying garbage in, garbage out, and that's exactly the case. If the DNxHR file looks terrible, then the resulting video will look terrible as well. I might need to look into that as well. If there are any updates, for example, if I know why this Cineform video had less bitrate in handbrake, or if I can somehow fix Cineform playback, or if I can fix these lines in DNxHR, I will write a pinned comment. If not, then I never fix these issues and they aren't fixable. But yeah, in the comparisons, you can compare for yourself what amount of quality is enough. To conclude, uncompressed is unfeasible. Maybe if you have a really, really awesome SSD, it's usable, but otherwise, just don't use it. H.264 is terrible. It looks terrible. It takes way too long to render for some reason. DNxHR and Cineform is the comparison. In both cases, use MOV, and for DNxHR, use variable. I can recommend that much. If you don't mind higher render times and larger files, probably use Cineform because it looks better. And if you use VLC media player, not MPCHC. If you use MPCHC and you need to look at the source video, most of the times you don't need to look at the source video, but if you need to do it and you use MPCHC, or you need faster render times or smaller file sizes, then go to DNxHR. That's the conclusion. Again, if there are any changes in my conclusion, or if there are any fixes for any problems that I pointed out in this video, there will be a pinned comment where I explain it. Besides that, you just saw all the settings I used for this test. If you see that some setting was terrible, or if you want me to test another codec, just write it in the comments. I wanted to also test out Kakadu, but you can only use it in the premium version, and I have the free version of Resolve. Everything in this video applies to the free version and to the premium version as well, except for in the premium version you have more codecs to choose from, like one or two more, and maybe one of them is better. That's it for the video. I will see you in the next one. Bye.